गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, कर्मणो अधिकरस्ते मा फलेषु गदासना मा कर्म फल हेतु भूस्माते संयुक्त कर्माणि। सो विदाउट एक्सपेक्टेशन इन रिजल्ट यू शुड डिवोट योर ड्यूटी उज्जवल। सो यू शुड डिवोट विदाउट एक्सपेक्टिंग एनी रिजल्ट। सो रिजल्ट इज इन द हैंड ऑफ गॉड। सो दैट इज दी टुडेज फिलोसफी। टुडे वंस अगेन वी स्टार्ट सम फिलोसफी। Yes, karma no adhikaraste, you have the right power. Ma phalesu karasana, do not expect result. Karma no adhikaraste, ma phalesu karasana, ma karma phalesu husmate sandukta karmani. You devote your time for work, not for the result. Result is in the head and heart. Okay, this is a philosophy, not a religious thing. Anyway, so we have to continue march forward in it. And one thing you have to understand that even in COVID time also, your period of your training is not going to be extended. What is gone is gone. So how much you can extract with this period of time, that is enough. It is turning time, it is a learning time, and it is a formidable time. So you have to devote whatever possible. So in because of the COVID, your training period will be not extended. So it is the same period. So that is why there is a lot of constraint. Even then you try to go with it. So utilize your time and diffusion for learning. That is most. That is why we are trying to do in even in an adverse situation also. That is the basic principle of doing all this thing. Anyway, that is going on. Simultaneously you have to master. There is no excuse. Anyway, so basic thing is that while doing the DSS, there are so many instruments, so many implants are coming in the field of your DSA, even a cochlear flexor. Cochlear flexor and flexor neck tremors are two conditions where a lot of evolutions are going on. Even then, there is no device available in the world today that it is the best. So there is a shortfall also here, there is failure also. That is why selection of the is more important and testing is very important. Basic principles are very important. It is not how to put it. No, you have to understand the basic principle. And that is one of the reasons of DSS I have already mentioned, the selection of the cases is very important. So do not select the cases which is unstable type in advance. So I told you that in cochlear flexor, I'm not going to talk about the flexor pattern and other thing. Only stable and unstable thing. So that is according to the advanced classification. That about the flexor line, we have discussed already. What is reversibly, we have discussed. What is commutative flexor. And also the criteria that which is stable and unstable, we have already discussed. And because of the tech, principle that DSS is basically a type of your, what type of principle here? This is tension band. So we must know that tension band principle is that while you are going to apply, that the opposite cortex should to be in contact. If there is no contact between the way, it is going to fail. So that is basic one of the reason. And if it is not there, and you have to convert it. So if you want to move forward DSS and there is a medial discontinuity, then you convert it to be stable, then you go for DSS. Yes, so if there is a combination there, there is no continuation in the postmedial, there is no support, and if a DSS is being applied, so it is going to fail. So this was the thing happening in the last couple of years, two, three decades before, because people try to apply DSS everywhere, so which is not indicated. That is why a lot of complications came. And that is why nowadays it is said that it is better to go for the DSS in case of stable type of flexor, not the unstable type. Unstable type, you have to go for the adamantium treatment, which includes the DCS. Then your plates are coming up, also locking plates are coming up. Now, proximal femur locking plates are coming up. Then also PFN is coming up. So many things are coming up nowadays in the field. So that is basically that there is a failure in the DSS also. And I already told you about the screw. Where is the screw? We have already discussed. Today I will talk about something about the research group. That will be there. Okay. So I have already talked about the research group. Huh? This group I have talked. So let us talk about the implants first. What are the things there? What are the peculiarities there? Do we have a short barrel here? Short barrel, yes. Short barrel and long barrel. So these things should be understood and why you have to select this sort of. This is also important. The selection of the implants. And the angle of the ear, these things are important. So now I am talking about this thing. I am talking about thing. I have already discussed about this screw. So I am not going to repeat the same thing. That it is around 22, diameter is 12.5, yes or no? Which is TMM? One turn if you do it, which is going to TMM is focusing. Then we have also talked about the diameter of this. This thing is supposed to know. Sometimes you may be asking the examination also. Tell us the peculiarities of this. Yeah. Yes, so diameter, length, yes. And about the plate also. See, if these plates are, see this, see, yeah, two types of plates are here. See, one plate is short barrel. You can make up from this here. So the one is short and one is deep. Yes or no? So you have to be careful selecting the barrel also. Where to select the short, where to select the long one. Yes, and what is the principle behind it? One point. Number 2 point is the plate angle. Number 3 point is also the hole. You see the hole. Here it is oval shaped. And here it is. It is oval shaped. It is almost round. Round shaped. So there is certain advantages, disadvantages of selecting the screw also. Nowadays, people are coming with the locking device also here. So in the osteopathic fixation, so I have to better fixation. See? Now, since we have discussed about this screw, we are not going to talk about this. We are going to talk about the plane. Now, one thing is that it is the angle. Angle is most of the time we are using 135 degree angle. But certain things are very important. See, I have already discussed that the CCD, caput calum, this angle is not in same in all the cases. You must understand this point. Caput calum. So, sometime I have already told you this camera, somebody can see the other. If you take the AP view, you'll see the other side. You'll find the head is almost straight one. And some ladies are coming, particularly elderly persons are coming with the angle like this. So here you need to change the angle also. Ideally, this is 135 degrees. Yes or no? So variable is there. So conventionally this. But ideally, if you talk about the axis of weight bearing, it is ideal if you put the implants in the axis of weight bearing. So it will be a weight bearing implants. So if it is supporting the axis of weight bearing, axis of weight bearing is actually 150 degrees. This angle. So this is being done because you have the compression trabeculae and tension trabeculae. Compression trabeculae, tension trabeculae, except trabeculae indicates what? Trabeculae indicates your axis, one line of your weight bearing. So if you follow that point, you're supposed to go for 150 degrees. But if you go for 150 degrees, it is too inferior and it may cut through it to a lot of bones and it's not very suitable to fix. That is why you are selecting. So in the ideal case, it is 150 degrees because this is the axis of your weight bearing axis. So though it is weight bearing axis 150 degree, we are selecting 135 most of the time. Actually not in the same axis of weight bearing. But if you go for the weight bearing, there are a lot of problems there because you need to cut for the bones and then it is not good. One point. Chika sir, that is one. So angle, that is one angle. Number 2 point is then in the holes, I have told. So as I said, there are holes. See, one thing you can make out from the also, some plates are coming with a the holes are, see, they are not in the same axis. The holes are. This is also important. See, usually DSS holes are like this. It is not in the same plane. They are not in the same plane. They are like this. So this is good because if you have a very same line axis, so this line becomes very weak. So too many screws cross, so that part becomes weak. So if it is zigzag sort of thing, this is better. So that is the principle of one of these DSS. Right? That is one point. Number 2 point is where holes are again oval or round. So round hole plates are there, minus point is there. You cannot give additional compression. So while we talk how to give compression there, we talk about how to give compression there at the flexor side because you can exert compression during the MA operation and also the device is going to cause compression, control collapse or compression at the flexor side. Right, because of the muscles pulls and the force working around it and the device assisting it to go for more compression, subsequently it is very dynamic. So it's a DSS. So compression is there. So, but initially during time of operation also you can give additional compression there. How to give, we'll talk. We have already discussed when repeating. So these holes also help you because you know the oval hole, if you put the screw, it can go for the compression one. Then again, plates are coming like this, there is a wavy plate like this. So this is basically the osteoporosis extension, so same thing. So if the plate screw is here, another screw is here, another is here. So you can have an extension of the plate like this. Sometimes again, devices are coming to give extension in the plate to give support in the combination with the support. So many things are there, modification. And how many holes, that is also important. It is most of the time it is seen the biomechanically only two holes are enough. But if there is a flexor extending down below, probably that is not treatable. So if the stable flexor, only two screws are enough. Stable flexor, suppose there is a flexor line here, everything is fine, good quality bone, only two screws are enough. Short bearing. Okay? So sometimes short bearing DSS screws are also being used flexor neck femur also. So going for DSS in flexor neck femur. Yes, flexor neck femur also people use DSS with derotation screw. So there you don't need to have a very long plate. Long plates are mostly selected only in those cases when very bones are osteoporotic or there is an extension down below. So you need to go for long plate. Otherwise, only two holes are enough to give the good better process. Clear? So the, I'm talking about. Now next point is in the burial tree. See, selections of the burials are also important. So, one is your compression screw, we'll talk about this. Burials are two. One is short, one is year long barrel. Yes, so this is 38. Almost 38. 30 mm, right? Yes. This is 25. Just try to remember that you have a two compression screw. Two types of your compression screw. So try to remember assembling here also. So you have a two, this is both are long, 36 and 29. 36 and 29. Other one is 38. And is 25. Understood? Yes, sir. So 29, 36, then 38, and 38 and 25. So now why you are selecting this sort of place from? This also understand. See. So if you want to give a plate like this, so supposing the neck is very short. Neck is very short, 70. So the necessarily you are going to select this short. Now, if it is short, that means it is very short one. And in this case, if you are using a very long barrel, what will happen? It will approximating with the base of this head. So if it is coupling like this, is it going to give your compression here? So it is already intact, no contact. So there is no question. So that is the invisible. So why it is said around you must have 20 mm here. So to have this, you have to calculate it, which plate is going to fit. Understood or not understood? So to advise to have effective compression in the flexor side, you have to select the barrel long or short. The principle behind is that you must give sufficient space to compress. If you have no space in between, so there is no question of compression. Understood? Not understood. It is true. So that is why the two bells are coming up. Is it short face, short, long and long? Supposing if you have a long bell. Again, another point you see. Another point. Supposing very long screw and you are using a short bell. Is it ideal? No, why this not like this? Tell me. So see, if the barrel is only putting this mass, very short. So see, there is a tendency to angulate it. So if there is a tendency, so there is a friction and it is not going to give you the sliding. Understood? Not understood. So that means you must have a sufficient part of the screw lying inside the barrel. That is where you will play. Otherwise, if you are giving a very very short barrel in a long screw, that will go and leave is like this. See, it is not going to help you. So to have effective, that means it's supposed to have at least 20 inside. So if it is inside sufficiently, that will help you to do so. So if it is lying like this, it is not going to do. Mechanically, see, kaise? So that is thing. That is why you should not. You have to logic to select. Then what I am going to select? So necessarily, in case of short screw, 70, 65, necessarily what? You have to solve it. Right? If you are giving long barrel, there is no space in between. So you supposed to say, see, there is almost area of 20. Almost your ratio of 20. It is, I said what? 22. So I said what? 20. Almost 20. Almost what? 20. So 20, 22. Almost roughly 20, 20. You measure 20 almost roughly. 20 here, 20 inside. So this is the selection criteria principle of your screw. And this is the principle of selecting the barrel. You are supposed to understand the basic principle. What principle is going to work? So you should not select it this way, that way. So how to have the effective biomechanics? You must select the adequate size. This part is clear to all. You saw it. Understood or not understood? Yes, this thing, that is why I am taking to talk about this here. That you have to adhere to the principle of selecting the screws length as well as the barrel length also. And selecting the plates. I have. Okay, sir. This part is clear. So next point is there, before putting the operation, the patient is in the traction, alignment, only thing important. And reduction is very important. If you are unable to have a reduction there, so it is going to fail. So you try to bring the fragment towards the alignment. So if the fragment is lying in the posterior, that means if you are going for this screw, this is a central, this part it is not going to be central. Yes? Again, the varus valgus is there. So axis is not there. So it may go cut short. It may go too much inferior. So four things may happen. If the, supposing there is a fracture here, marker pen too. So there is a fracture here. So there is a fracture here. And you see the reduction is that this fragment is a bit down and this fragment is up. Fine. AP view is good. The lateral view, not good. But you have accepted it. This is going to do damage. Because here, this screw gonna get where it will be central. But here, it will be going too much posterior. Yes or no? So again, same thing, if the fragment is going down below, this fragment up, you are putting this screw, you will find it is going to the anterior. Again, if this alignment, you are going to go 135 most of the time. Okay, fine. So that is why it is here. Fixed angle almost 135 is available most of the time. But many times there is adjustable angular device is there. Adjustable. So you can adjust the angle. As I say, yes? So as I said, this angle is about 5 degree increment, 135, 130, 135, 140, 145, up to 150, most of the time, commonly available. This is available, but conventionally you use 135. Yes, sir? So 135, that means your alignment should be like this. So that is why this reduction is very important. If it is too much varus, anyone going to be, it going to go superiorly. Too much valgus reduction, then it is going to inferiorly. Right? So that is one. The reduction is must. So reduction is must. Sometime you may take the help of K-wear. So you can pass the K-wear from here. You can pass the K-wear here. So the in such a way that while doing all these rimming and other things, it should not come in between. See? So this K-wear fixation sometimes is important after reduction so that it is maintained. So this process, the reduction is acid, but it should to be maintained till your instrumentation. So if your reduction is okay, but suddenly it is going down up. So it is going to fail again. But it is why if the relaxation is not maintained, you may take the help of the caver to fix it temporarily and place it in such a way that it is not going to interfere in your subsequent instrumentation technique. Understood? So that is why you may find, you may put a caver from the superior part here. Superiorly, even anterior, posterior also sometimes. So this is going to help you. And this is more important particularly in case of your, if you're going to flexion and femur. And also temporary fixation is going to help you in other way also. I'll tell you how. How this temporary fixation is going to help you in final compression. I'll tell you. Putting. Okay? That is another thing I'll tell you. That is why sometimes people used to go, I need to hold bone. Bone holding also some used to do. Holding the bone like this. Devices are available so that you can hold it. Bone holding. Ultimate thing is a reduction and maintenance is a reduction till the instrumentation. So you can take the various instrument to help you to maintain the reduction. Must. That is basic. Now next point is the Putting the guide wire. The basic principle in guide wire articulation is that this is bull eye. Bull eye. This is bull eye. This is called bull eye. So it should be central. So I will talk about the principle here. So if you are putting a guide wire like this, I am putting a guide wire like this. So usually what? This is your superior attachment of the vastus lateralis. You have to split it. Somebody used to cut it like this and retract it, or somebody going to split it. Very fair person used to better to go for this. Thin person, you can do a nick here and retract it and you can enter it. Yes, sir? Okay, that is one. Usually, it is at the level of lesser trochanter. Entry point is at the level of lesser trochanter, usually. So you find the lesser trochanter level, you have to enter one point. Number two is that 5 degree this going down below and 5 centimeter, 5 centimeter going above, it will reflect 5 degree angulation. So 1 degree, 1 mm is equal to 1 degree. If you are going to my inferior, that means it is also reflected here because the entry is like this. So it is going for 100 degree. So entry point is very important. So entry point is not in such a way that your loss man of the guide wire should be the central and bull end. So this is important to understand that I am going to pass it. So you need to take it because most important thing is the placing the guide wire in the right position. So if you are unable to place the guide wire in the central part, it is going to fail. So the idea is that where is bull eye? That means the central, you have to put it in central. So central. How central? AP view central and lateral view central. So that is ideal. Yes, sir? So to some extent, people used to say a bit inferiorly, a bit posteriorly accepted. So if it is going a bit posteriorly, suppose the entry point going like this, so this is a part of the head construction and the superior, inferior, medial, lateral head. So if it is lying this inferiorly, it is to some extent acceptable because it is safe. So if it is a cut through also, it will take a lot of time to cut through. So you have, so if it is like this, if it is going inferiorly, limb is tight rooted like this. So there is a tendency to go for the implant like this. So at least you will get more bone to cut. Yes, sir? So most of them is anteriorly or superiorly is going, not posteriorly, cut through. So that is why the question of TED is coming. So you know that TED is a tip apex distance. Tip apex distance, that means your distance from the tip of the seal. Or finally, while we are talking about the screw, the tip. Apex is the head. So this in AP view and in the lateral view should less than 25. 22, good. Okay. So it should be less than 20. So if it is more, that means your placement is not right. Either it is going posteriorly or superior, whatever my displacement is not right. So to make this placement right, always try to have a bull's eye. So hit it in central. That is more important. Understood? Now, next point is how far is supposed to go. People used to say you can lodge it up to the acetabular ground. But better not to go, but there is a concept. because while doing all this, it should not go away, coming out. So you have to lodge it in subcondyle or up to the subcondyle. Lodgement. It is nicely fitted, done, everything. So you are taking the help of your angular guide like this. So you are putting this guide like this. No idea, but anyway, so you have to put it like this and push the guide to the center. Center like this. So it should be center. Bull's eye. Put AP and attention. Next one is how far you supposed to go. Now next one is then after placement, you need to go for the ringing. You have to make the hole. So to lodge this stool. Why not? So you have to cut. So you know this is called tibulumar. Why this is called? This is one. This is going to correspond this one. This is one. Number one. Number two, this is for the barrel. This one is for the barrel. And this is also important, this part. If you're not going too far up to the base, this part, you have to be remembered, then this is not going to lodge this part. So this is very important. So this angle should to be plus. So if it is, supposing if you have done a drill such as that, you have done the drilling up to this, rimming. So rimming can be done, sometimes people used to go hand technique, and people used to go for the rimming technique also. But anyway, the tripulimar is to loss here, then you do rimming. So there are two techniques are available. One is called your rimming technique with the help of this is handler. So you can use it. So this is most of the time southern event. So soft tissue bone if you have, so you can do it yourself. Yourself we have a control. And you have to go up to what extent now. Now next one is gradually place nicely. Next one is you have to ring. Ringing up to what extent? Up to this is important. And these are this, they are not same. See, look at this. So this is for DCS. So you can make up from here. There are two. They are not same actually. This is flat. So this is for the DCS. And you see this is for obliquation. So this is for DSS. So do not mix it. So DCS and DSS. So there are two. So you have to take out. And this part is very important so that the angular part is lost. Otherwise, if it is not going, that means you are not able to flush the plane along with this here. It may overhang. Right? So there will be gap. Understood? So rimming is important. Now how far rimming? Rimming should to be done in case of your adult bone, 10 mm from the subcondyle bone up to osteotic bone up to 5 and 10. Osteotic up to 5 and in case of adult bone up to 10. So you have to go. That means your idea is that you should lock this tip of the screw at the subcondyle bone, strongest part. Subcondyle. Yes, if you keep it short, it's not good. It's supposed to be at this subcondyle bone. So in case of osteopathy up to 5, in case of adult up to 10. Understood? Okay. Now next one is that you have to put this screw inside. Now, two types of things are there. One, that we have to do the measurement also. With the help of the guide rail, one can do direct and indirect measurement also. There is simple technique and after doing the reading, you can do for direct reading. Otherwise, that part is helpful to tell you the how far you are going, this is going to give the measurement. You subtract it and you know how far it is inside. So you can measure this from this measuring device. Or after this ring, one can go for direct also. So this hole is made, you can directly measure it. So how far I'm going with the another kind of putting inside. You can do. That is direct and one is interactive. So number three. Is that whether rimming should be done or not? It is said in an osteoporotic bone, you may not need to go for rimming, elderly patient. But young patient may need to go for rimming. Tapping. So tap should be done. Tapping should be done. The tapping should be done in case of your your so tapping should to be done in case of strong bone, or tapping may not be necessary to do in case of your osteoporotic bone. So you can do the remaining here of tapping. So tapping may or may not. Very osteoporotic bone may not need to do, but very strong bone, young adult, you are doing so, you have to go for it. Yes, sir. Number two. Okay, tapping. Then clean it with normal saline, detergent, debris, all these things should be removed so that the encourage is better. Yes, next point is that one thing you need to understand is that while putting this screw inside, now you need to put this screw inside. You need to put this. So you need to put this screw inside. Now while you are putting this screw, you know, you are going. Now your idea is that this is not round. You can make out that this is, there is a slot there. So this supposed to correspond to this slot of here. So while you are placing, finally it's supposed to be like this. So you can make out this slot is corresponding to the smooth surface. It's not round. This is not round. So this is a flat. See this part, this is not round exactly. So this is flat. This is flat surface. So your alignment should be there that the screw is placed at the flat surface to above and down. So that the plate is going to correspond with it. Plate is going to lodge. Yes, so if it is like this, you cannot negotiate it because plate should be coming to the long axis of your long bone. Yes, sir. So, but here one important thing is that, so final while you are doing the tightening, in case of young man, final lodging, if you do more tightening, you may find a time may come, it is locked in such a way that instead of this thread going inside the bone, it may tend to rotate the bone itself. So this lead to your dislocation of your reduction. This is very important. So that is why many a times one may need to additionally hold the bone at the time of doing, I mean, so put in this screw, or the KYRO is going to help you in this case to keep it in position. So, but if you are doing it too much, so if you play this, so supposing head bend like this, so it is, so play this not flushing with this your barrel. Now what you are going to do? You are trying to do it like this, try to push it, but while doing the pushing, you are rotating the head also. So this is very important to understand. So final placement is very important. Try to put it in a horizontal way, so the slot is almost parallel to the long axis. This flat surface is superior and inferior. But if you are placing it a bit obliquely like this, so the plate is going to couple with this like this. In this situation, if you hammer it or do something to do it, to bring it here, so what you are going to do? You are trying to rotate the head along with it. And this should lead to your lossment, displacement of the flexor side. So this part should be carefully monitored beforehand. So your thing is to be parallel. Otherwise, if you're forcefully down below, it can come, but at the cost of your loss of your reduction. Okay, sir? So this is very important. And finally, your coupling with plate here. Then after that, this Teflon headed, your inductor is going to help you to push it more hard, and it is being flushed along with the bone. It is being flushed along with the bone. So this should be like this at a time. So it should be flushed. So it should be flushed like this. So it should come like this. Eh? So there should not be any gap in between the hair. No gap. No gap. It's a press picture. So it shouldn't be. Yes? So now, everything is fine. Now, impaction is done. So Now you can do what next? It is fixation of plane. Which screw supposed to be fixed first? Always try to put the distal screw first. Why? Because it is important that if you fix the proximal screw, you may find the plate is not actually in the air. So there may be some sort of going up or going down. To make it more central, you try to place this screw first distal one. So once this distal is locked in central and other will also definitely. So you may find that if it is hidden within in the muscle tube, you have not noticed that part. But you will finally see that this is okay. These proximal screws are okay. But the distal more screws are either lying eccentrically. So to avoid this complication, you try to put the distal screw first. That will keep the plate nicely with this bone. Yes or no? So if you fix the top proximal screw, you will find this very central, but tip is lying up or down. So this one. So finally, rest of the screws are same. And at the last, what you are going to do, compression screw. This is not very essential. This compression is not very essential. Even then, it can help you do the compression at the flexor side. 5 mm. It can give additional 5 mm compression. One. So how to exercise compression at the flexor side? One, to release the traction. So it will compress, push. One, at the flexor side. Number two, this screw, as I said, 2936. Going to help you compression at the flexor side. Number two. Number three, the plate device itself. Also help to do some sort of compression. Yes? So all these things all together going to get flexor compression at the time of the operation. At the time of the operation, there is a good one. And subsequently, because of the barrel technique, sliding technique, because of the action of the muscles, there is a compression at the flexor side, sliding technique. So this is additional. So this is how do you need to do the fixation. Yes, technical part. And subsequently, one need to do the posterior X-ray to evaluate how is the fixation, how is the contact between the bone, and what about the posterior inferior vertical part contact of this area, and stability and also tension. Depending upon which, you can allow the patient to walk or do mobilizations. So if your fixation is not very strong, bones are osteoporotic, your tail is not good, do not allow the patient to move, otherwise it will cut through. So if everything is fine, patient replacement is very good, centrally good, everything, you can start early working also. So post-operative period is also important, and post-operative X-ray evaluations, particularly see how the fixation is very important. Then subsequent period, how much freedom you can give to the patient is determined by the post-operative X-ray evaluation. That I am very happy, bone is very strong, head is less than 25, contact of the bone is good, I can give. But if it is compromised, better not to give. Otherwise, it may cut through. So many problems. So this is your today's class. Do you have anything to ask? Do you have anything to ask?